Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Sunshine Islands. I went ahead and finished up day 3 and slept. We're now in day 4. And we'll just start with the usual checking up on our plants. You can see here that our turnips have evolved to the next stage. Most plants have 3 stages. They'll have the seed stage, and then they'll have this middle stage where they've grown but they're not quite ripe, and then they'll have their ripened stage where you can actually pick them. And again, it's complicated to grow crops in this game because each stage has a certain amount of water and sun points that it needs and a certain amount of days. But again, we are just starting out with turnips, and they are very, very easy to grow, and as long as you just kind of keep it equal parts water and equal parts sun, it should be fine. I could probably stand to water these one more time, but I'm gonna wait to hear from Taro first before I make that choice, because if it's raining tomorrow, I wouldn't want to water them again. I spent some time collecting some wood. I've chopped, I think, 26 pieces. On the emulator, I'm finding this is probably one of the only graphical errors I've found so far where the number is hidden behind the item, and I'm not sure why that is, and I haven't found a way to fix it. Like these bamboo shoots, for example. I have no idea how many bamboo shoots I have. Obviously, I have 3, but I'm not able to see the 3 under there. So that's kind of a bit of a pain, but I'm not too worried about it. I also have to keep an eye on my stamina and my fullness. You can see there that even though I slept, my stamina and my fullness are getting pretty low, so it's time to eat something. And Taro is telling us that it's gonna rain tomorrow. It's gonna drizzle, so that'll mean I'll get 1 point of water. So I'm gonna leave those turnips alone, and I'm not going to water them. I'm gonna just wait and get some water on them tomorrow. I'm gonna do my usual rounds and speak to some people. Unfortunately, even though I've been given an axe and I've been given a hammer, I'm not really going to be able to use it all that much just because I have to be so careful about my stamina and my fullness level and try not to sort of overdo it. I've opted to gather lumber first. Stone is important, but for most of our buildings, you need lumber and not stone. So I'm gonna kind of try and pick up all of the pieces of wood if possible. Another really cool thing that I want to show you guys, this is a little bit of a time saver, or it can be, and you can do this if you want to. I'm gonna talk to Sabrina here, hiding from me. Talk to these people first, and then I'll show you what I wanted to show you. Do I have an inventory space? Let's see. Yes, I do. Alright, so you can see that there are pieces of wood and rocks on the map. If I want to, I could put these in my bag. And these will stack, which is nice. I don't have to go into my inventory and reorganize them. So I'm gonna put them in my bag and carry them around with me, and then what I can do is I can bring them back to my farm and put them on my farm. And you may ask yourself, well, why is that useful? You're just packing more junk over to your farm. But the reason that that can be useful for some people is you don't have to travel as far. You don't have to spend time walking all the way to the beach to pick up and chop down pieces of wood. And on a day like tomorrow, for example, when it's raining, it's not a bad idea to pick up some branches, bring them back to the farm, and then you can just spend your day on the farm if you want to. You don't have to go out. I'm gonna go ahead and just eat a couple of things here to get my stamina and fullness up a little bit. Fullness is still an issue. I'm not finding that these herbs are doing much to help my fullness out as much. I've sort of made my rounds and I've spoken to everybody now, so I guess I'll go to Chen's store and I'll think about buying some more crops as well. We also have the option to grow some potatoes, and as you can see, I've got $1,400, which I've made just by shipping stuff. I'll buy a couple of those, and I'll think about growing some of those when my turnips come in. I don't want to start planting and watering and taking care of too many things, because at this point in the game, I'm only able to water one square at a time, which is so painful and so time consuming, and it also takes up a ton of stamina. Alright, so if we select our branches, you can see here that I can throw them onto my field without actually throwing them away. And these will be here for me tomorrow. So if you're not using this part of your field, then it is useful, I think anyways, to keep all of the materials in one area. And you can do the same thing with stones. Because the longer you keep stones and pieces of wood out onto the map, the less chance you're gonna get to get herbs and flowers and things like that from popping up. And those items are seasonal, so you might miss the opportunity to get as many items if the map is being clogged up with stones and pieces of wood. So it's completely up to you what you want to do, but I will probably just spend the rest of my time here gathering up some materials and bringing them back to the farm. I've been selling off all of this seaweed because I don't see myself really needing it. I might save a couple and try to use them at the cafe or the diner. But I also don't have a fridge right now. I don't have a shelf. Like, I have no space. I've got no space to keep anything. This game has a really, really, really slow start. And it's really hard for me to go from having, like, almost $1,000,000 in my file and all of this advancement to going to this and having, like, nothing. Alright, so I'm gonna throw my rocks onto the field here before I go to bed. You don't have to do it for all of them. You can also use these to make fences for your animals as well. You can just pick up these stones and put them in such a way where when you get animals, they'll be protected from wild dogs. You can use the stones around the perimeter to, like, decorate if you want to. If you want to section off what you're growing or keep better track, you know, making a bridge of stone or something might not be a bad idea. And then I've got a couple of pieces of actual lumber, which I can probably put into my material shed here. So we can throw that in. And then you can see on the assets screen that it's now showing me as having 26 pieces of lumber, the basic shed, the one that we have right now without any upgrades, can hold 999 pieces of each. So don't worry about running out of space. You should be fine. 999 pieces is quite a bit, especially even just for starting out. The other thing that I like to do in this game, because the weather system is just so complicated, is I like to save my game before I go to bed. So for example, if my turnips died, so say they died, for example, I could then reload my game before I went to bed, and I could try and give it more water and see if it was missing water. Because I've already watered these, I'm not able to give it less water, but you can play around a little bit with how your crops are growing that way. It might also be a good idea for you to save your watering until the end of the day. Make a save before you start watering. Water. And then go to bed and check how it is in the morning, and then if it's good, keep playing. If not, reload it and fix it. And I have done that trick many, many, many a time. I've had to do a lot of saving and reloading in order to try and save my crops. I have a visit from Taro this morning. I think you're ready to learn about harvesting. Do you want me to teach you? No. You already know all about harvesting. That's the kind of confidence I like to see. I'll be going then. Bye. Yeah, so he's basically just saying, hey, your crops are ready. Which is pretty basic, and they're not actually ready to go, so that would have been completely pointless. It still needs a couple more days of water, I think. It only had sunshine at this stage with no water, so we need to let it go until tomorrow and see where it's at. And I'll go over a couple of things to mention about harvesting, but for the most part, it's pretty self-explanatory. You just walk up to the crop, you press A, it gets added to your inventory, and then you can ship it. We're gonna have another sunny day tomorrow, which is great. Just do my rounds here and speak to people. Again, at this point in the game, they don't trust me enough to have me give them presents. Although, it's day 5. I started talking to everybody on day 2, so I might have luck giving people gifts. I can try it with Julia. I have an item, or I can buy an item for $10 that I know she'll like. And if not, then it'll be tomorrow that they'll start allowing me to give them presents. And now this sucks because I've only got one inventory space. When your actual inventory slots get full in your rucksack, it'll start placing items into any empty tool slot that you have. I'm trying to save all of my flowers for gifts, for when people actually start to allow me to give them gifts. But I can probably go sell a couple of bamboo shoots, I can probably go sell some of these weeds. I don't need to be this much of a pack rat. And normally I would store the stuff I'm not using, like I would store my sickle, I would store my potato seeds, but I don't have any means of storing anything right now, unfortunately. I also forgot to read the signs outside of each of these stores, but they also all have a one day of the week that they're closed, But it's kind of nice because the only three stores in town that have a closing date are all closed just throughout the weekend. So Chen's is closed on Fridays, Mirabelle is closed on Saturdays, and Gannon is closed on Sundays. Other than that, everything else is open all the days of the week. So let's see. I'm gonna buy a piece of pet food and I'm going to see if Julia will accept my gift. If she does, then that's great. I can start giving gifts to people, and if she doesn't, then I'm gonna have to wait an extra day. Yeah, so now she won't accept it. I don't feel like a gift right now, I'm sorry. Which means she doesn't trust me. And that's the same for every villager. And I did mention this before, you have to talk to them several days in a row to gain their confidence. And if you go several days without talking to them, and you try to give them a gift, they'll ignore you, and you have to repeat the process all over again. But once you've befriended somebody, I think you can ignore them for much, much longer than like 5 or 6 days before they won't accept your gifts. So it's just the initial hurdle of actually taking the time to talk to everybody that's a little irritating. So hopefully tomorrow I can start getting rid of some of these flowers. I think every single girl except for Natalie likes flowers. Eliza likes flowers, the little girl with the blonde hair. So I'll definitely have some uses for them and can get rid of them and start to befriend people. And I've got a little bit of money. I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go to Carol's here and I'm going to buy something for my fullness level. Cooking is absolutely hands down the best way to get your fullness and your stamina up. But I found that one of the best food items that you can buy in a pinch is the sandwich. The sandwich is 200 bucks. And you get a pretty decent amount of fullness and stamina out of it. And even in my game where I've played for like a super long time and I have a great kitchen, I've got all these recipes, I find myself just coming to the cafe often and just grabbing a sandwich. Right now, because I don't have unlimited funds, that is not the best option. That's a better option if you have a ton of money to use. But 200 bucks isn't gonna hurt me because sooner than later I am gonna be able to harvest all of those turnips. And my rucksack right now is completely full. There's nothing else that I can pick up, so it's time to go back to the house. And as you can see here, just as an example, all of these flowers and these herbs and these things showed up because I cleared the beach of the rocks and the pieces of wood yesterday. So as you can see, there's a lot of maintenance in this game. There's a lot of stuff that you have to kind of keep up with, but it makes the game go by really fast. It keeps you busy. I mean, it's not the worst thing in the world. So I'll probably continue on my day just gathering stuff. I'm gonna go ahead and sell this seaweed. I don't need it. Go ahead and sell these weeds. Go ahead and put the branches out in my field here. So our turnips should be ready to go tomorrow, I hope. Or the next day. I should start planting those potatoes. And once we have a little bit of money, we can look at what sort of upgrades we want to look at buying first, whether it's a rucksack upgrade I want to buy first, or whether we want to start working on some buildings to get some animals. Either way, we'll figure it out. So I'm gonna stop it here because it's gonna be much of a repeat of what you've already seen. And I will sleep and I will see you on spring day 6. Thank you also very much for watching, and I hope that I will see you next time.